Hi, Alex here from Rebeloper.com. Welcome back to my channel, the number one place for iOS developers who want to code smarter. In today's video, I am going to talk about how to use texts inside stacks in SwiftUI. If you'd like to build out this interface with just a few minutes, then keep on watching. So hit that subscribe button if you're excited to dive into this. And make sure to watch the full video to find out the surprise bonus. So let's jump right into Xcode 11. So let's see, I'm on beta, but this will work fine for you once it is out of beta, of course. So let's create a new project. Okay, so this is the default one, the one that I have already created, but let's see, single view app. Let's click on next here and I will name this, let's see, make sure that the language you select is Swift and the user interface is SwiftUI, of course. So let's click on next here and I will just drop it right here. I will create a Git repository on my Mac so I can push it up to GitHub so you can take a look at it. So go ahead and take a look at the links in the description. So let's create this. And while we create it, let me just resize this so you can see everything. And as you can see, we have a kind of an Xcode 11 style here, but I will just close this one and maybe resume the preview here. And first of all, what we are going to do is create some new texts. Okay, well, if you come from UI kit land, then texts are kind of text fields or text labels rather. And there we go. We have a hello word there. So let me just change this to hello text. There we go. And as you can see, it automatically changed the live preview. So that is a real awesome. So what I want to do is create a text one here. And that will be a string. Let me just copy this out. Hello text. There we go. And hello text one. And I will add this variable to the text. Let's see how that goes. And it should update, but automatic preview updating paused. So let's click on a resume here. And we should see hello text one. Real soon. There we go. Hello text one. So what we want to do here is basically add some more text. Okay, so what I would do is just simply copy and paste all of these and maybe let's just create some new text strings here. And that will be, let's see, 2, 3, and there we go. 2 and 3, and let's change all of these. Okay, and while you are at it, as you can see, we have some issues here. First of all, we cannot have more views inside a view. So we kind of need to add it inside a stack. So that is what we are going to do next. But as the title of this video suggests, it's view, text, and stacks. So what is a view? Well, basically every element that you just add into this var body sum view is a view, be it a text, an image, a label, a button, whatever, it is basically a view. And just so you know, let's not go far into our conversation, but when you modify a text, and we'll do that in just a moment, it SwiftUI also creates a new view according to those specifications. Okay, so first of all, let's fix this. Okay, let's create a stack here. And if we go and type in here stack, okay, and we will use, let's see, a vertical stack. That's great. And let's add these three. So I'm just selecting the three lines and I'm using Alt Command and square brackets, and it is going to push that up. Okay, and if you use the other one, the closing square brackets, it will push the, all of your selected lines one down. Okay, and let's see, the preview is still working. Oh, so let's just add these two parentheses there. And there we go. We have hello text 1, hello text 2, hello text 3. Now let's add some modifiers to this text. And as you already saw, I'm using the code, so I'm using auto completion, but you could use these real nice helpers. So if you hit command and select, hover over the text and click on it, you will see a lot of actions that you can take on this element. And I will select show SwiftUI inspector. And there you go, we have the text, we could change that, or rather yet, we cannot change that, of course, because we are using a variable. The font, let's just change this to, let's say, large title. And as you can see, it already added the code into our editor. How awesome is that? And let's add our weight. Let's see, maybe bold here so we can see. And you saw that it added the font weight to dot bold. Okay, color, let's see, I will use, of course you have all of these system colors, but I would like to use, let's see here, let's see, orange maybe. Okay, color dot orange. Okay, let's go back and show SwiftUI inspector and see what else do we have here. Well, we could add some padding or frame to it, but we won't bother with that at this moment. Okay, now let's see. What if I want to, let's say, use all of these modifiers with the other text, so text 2 and text 3. So for that, here comes the bonus extra for this video. We are going to extract this to another SwiftUI view. So to extract our text with all of its modifiers into a subview, all we have to do is hit command and click on the text. And here you can see it says extract subview. So let's click on that. And if you wait just a few moments, it will highlight the extracted view, and I will call this hello view. You may call it whatever you'd like, okay? And hit a return. Now, if we just scroll a little bit down, you will see that it created a new struct with a hello view, and it has a body of a type some view, and it has some unresolved identifier. So to fix this problem, all we need to do is create a variable for it. So var, let's say, text string maybe, or something according to this. And this will be of type string, of course. And let's add this here. Okay. Now we will have another error, and it says hello world type is not convertible, and let me just tap on there, to string that is returning a hello view. So as you might have already guessed this, we want to add here a text string, and we are going to add text one here. Okay, and that should work fine. Let's hit resume. And we should see basically the same old thing. Now, what I want to change here still is the font type and maybe the color. So let's add some variables here. So let's see, var font. And that is of type font. Okay, and let's see, var foreground color. And that is of type color. Okay, and now I can just simply add these instead of the hard-coded types. Okay, there we go. Okay, of course, we need to add all of these here. So let's see, font dot, let's say title. Let's use title for now, not large title. And for the next one is the foreground color. Foreground color. And that will be, let's say, blue. Okay, that is that. Let's hit resume and see some changes here. And we will, of course, use this hello view to the other text. So let's delete this. And real quick, let me just copy and paste this and change some attributes. The first one is, of course, the text string free here. And maybe we want to have this as yellow and this as red. I know my font color, foreground color variations are quite hard. But there you go. We have our hello view with different texts and different colors. And finally, we want to have this as maybe something like subtitle, something like that. Let's see the auto completion. There we go. Sub headline. Yeah, we still need to have these names figured out. There we go. And as you can see, these are quite small. So I want to add them into a horizontal stack. So what I want to do is hit Command and tap on this second hello view and embed this into an HStack. So embed in HStack. And as you can see, just added HStack there. And just select this line or just get your cursor there and hit Command, Alt, and square brackets and move it up. And let's see there. There we go. Let me just make this a little bit larger so you can see that we have an horizontal stack. Now, I added these two parentheses because there could be some optional elements here, and I will show you one, and that is the spacing. You might want to use spacing. That is correct. And I want to add in here 50 so we can see all of it. As you can see, it already updated the preview. So that is it for views, texts, and stacks. Now you know how to use and modify text, put them into stacks, and create dynamic reusable views in SwiftUI. If you are more interested in SwiftUI tutorials, make sure to hit that notification bell, because in my next video, I'm going to talk about navigation in SwiftUI. This is gonna be a really cool video where I'm gonna share some key tips to make your navigation work seamlessly. So make sure you hit that notification bell so you don't miss that video. In the meantime, while you wait for that video, make sure you also check out these two videos that I have over here. I talk about iOS development, SwiftUI, and how to code smarter. So make sure to check out these videos as well. And as always, I will see you in the next one.